done here at a very long day, but of course we finish it up the way we started, namely with closing remarks from our host. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back on stage the director of the Latvian Institute of International Affairs, Andris SPRŪDS. Will remain as your backdrop, Andris. Yes.
Thank you, Ali. Madam President, it was an honor, it was an intellectual delight, inspiring, enriching, informative, so it was a real pleasure. And of course, it's not an easy to draw a conclusions after such a formidable and excellent panel. I think all of us have also our own specific vision, own emphasis, own angles where we look at the NATO developments. But I think that responding also to your question, NATO remains relevant, and NATO remains alive and strong, and certainly it will stay like this beyond 2030. But at the same time, as Secretary General said in the morning, we live in a strategic competition. We live in an environment of strategic competition. And it's not only about military strategic competition, it's also about competition for hearts and minds, about ideological competition in many ways. And that's why when we face our future challenges, the core tasks, of course, are always relevant. The core task of collective defense remains certainly the fundamental and basic core task, what we have already underlined for the last 70 years, and certainly so for the next, hopefully, 70 years as well. But same time, the core task is also to stay resilient. The societal resilience is extremely important, and it is about both hardware and software, hardware, critical infrastructure, increasingly artificial intelligence, increasingly digital critical infrastructure, which creates much more technological tasks to deal with challenges outside especially. But it is not less important to speak about a software of the societal resilience, namely about the sharing, the following the common values, about a cohesion of societies, about a being still pluralistic but engaging societies. And these are not an easy tasks. And that's why this event, I would say, it is about involving different and engaging different stakeholders, the decision makers, the thinkers, the diplomats, the youth, which is extremely important when we speak about the future tasks as well. So we have had a debate on future of Europe. So this was, in a sense, debate on future of NATO, and certainly it should be continued. And of course, it would be impossible without stakeholders in the room, without those who participated and listened. So I express many thanks and appreciation. Of course, I express my appreciation to all the speakers and participants who were willing, with Madam President, to share their insights, with moderators who, of course, moderated the panels. Ali, also, thank you so much to you. You are a chief moderator, and you remain so for Riga Security Forum, and we are very happy to have you on the board. Of course, it is about partners. It would be impossible to have event without engaging and supporting partners. The Latvian Ministry of Foreign Affairs, NATO, Friedrich Heffer Stiftung, and I can name additional institutions. So this is certainly a multi-player involvement and engagement and task. And the last but not least, I would like to say thanks to my institution's team. Cynthia, Martins, Karlis, Alexandra, and other colleagues and interns, it would be impossible to put it together without a active involvement of everyone. So thank you so much, and it should be continued. Thank you.